find a good way to play this. What's up guys, it's Kevin with 3rd Brand Technology. So for this video I'm going to be going over some of the constraints, options in Fusion 360. More of like an intro or trying to figure out how to work the constraints. So in the last video or a few videos ago, I downloaded Fusion 360 because I needed a new design software because 123D design is out of date. And so it's pretty much set up, and 123D design didn't use constraints or threads or anything like that. Pretty much it was just a basic software, very basic. But in this video I'm going to try to figure out how to use constraints in Fusion 360, just go over what they are and that type of stuff. So I'm going to go over some of the definitions of constraints and constraints in design software, and find a few videos or clips of how to use them by other YouTubers. But from what I've read online, there's like three main types of constraints. And then in Fusion 360, it gives you like 10 different options of making those constraints. Either making them perpendicular or tangent type stuff. So in Fusion 360, you can make a constraint in the sketch option. Once you hit finish on the sketch, you can't, there's no option to make constraints anymore. So if you're gonna make them, go make them in this optional, in this phase of the design. But anyways, I'm gonna cut to the screenshot, screen grab of it. That's where most of the video is gonna be focused on. If I have to do a 3D print of it, I'm at. So here is what Google Search returns. I'm going to look up constraints Fusion 360. So we can see a definition right here. Allows you to relate one sketch entity to another sketch entity. And we'll go to images. I'm going to see a few different things show up. So now we'll go to the Fusion 360 software and see if we can figure out how to work them. So here we are in the Fusion 360 design program. We're going to sketch a basic rectangle and then put a line through it. Just something to play around with. So here is a list of the constraints. So now I'm just going to play around with them, see if I can figure out how to work them. So these are apparently similar to stuff that you would have learned in a high school geometry type class. How the lines intersect each other in a perpendicular or parallel. I feel like I could probably make a second part to this video eventually, explain a little more in depth and get a little better at it as soon as I can figure out how to work them properly. Here's another definition or tip that I found online. It says a constraint in 3 modeling. It's basically a tool that helps you keep track of a certain amount of polygons you have in a 3 program. So if it's like a complex or really big object, it helps with that. And here's a diagram from the Wikipedia page on constraints. It gives like 3 or 4 different examples of how to use them or how to place the constraints on the objects. Okay, so constraints, to wrap up the video. So it essentially locks parts of the object or dimension sketch that you're doing in place. That way if you're working on multiple complex objects, you won't move one around accidentally. But there's a lot more in-depth stuff I'm going to with constraints. But this is just kind of like an intro to constraints. Just me figuring it out and explaining it to you guys. Kind of how to use it as a Fusion 360 for beginners type video. Anyways, that's gonna wrap up the video for this week. If I could be around to see your latest videos first, make sure to click subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time.